In this video, we will be demonstrating the fundamentals of GaussView. Topics include the main window, the toolbar, Inquire mode, mouse movements, modifying the display, multi-view windows, and preferences. This is the GaussView application. Its main features are the control window, containing the menu bar, the toolbar, and the current fragment window, and one or more windows containing molecules. GaussView also presents dialog boxes as needed for specific tasks. The toolbar is the primary control panel. It contains a variety of helpful tools. The tools are organized into groups of related items. The file group contains tools related to opening files and saving molecules, images, and videos. The edit group has tools for cutting and pasting, undo and redo, and modifying the complete molecular structure. The tools group contains advanced tools for modifying molecules. The builder group holds tools for building molecules from standard fragments, for modifying geometric parameters such as bond lengths and angles, and for selecting atoms within the molecule. The view group has tools for changing the visual appearance of a molecule view. The calculate Gaussian group offers tools for setting up and running Gaussian calculations. The calculation options group contains tools for managing jobs. The windows group provides tools for positioning windows on the screen. We will demonstrate many of these tools. These individual sub-toolbars can be rearranged by dragging them by the handle into a new position in the toolbar. A link to detailed information about customizing the toolbar is given at the end of the video. If you hover over a toolbar icon, its name will appear in a small pop-up. If you want to change the size of the toolbar icons, you can use the Icons item in the GaussView Preferences, which we'll see later in this video. The GaussView Help System can be accessed through the Help menu. The Menus and Icons item provides descriptions for all of the toolbar items and menu options. Help can also be accessed by clicking on any Help button. These Help buttons are context-specific and display help for the current tool or dialog. Inquire mode allows us to examine structural data for the current molecule. The information displayed varies depending on the number of atoms we select. Selecting one atom will display the element type and atom number. Two atoms will display the corresponding bond length. Three atoms will display the corresponding interatomic angle. And four atoms will show the dihedral angle corresponding to atoms 4, 3, 2, and 1. We can click anywhere in the open space to unselect all atoms. You can select any atom you want, whether or not they are bonded. For example, here we determine the distance between the two farthest apart hydrogen atoms. We can rotate, translate, and zoom the molecule in the view window using the mouse. The left mouse button rotates a molecule about the X and Y axes. The trackpad on laptops works like the left mouse button. The scroll wheel or middle mouse button moves the molecule within the view window. The right mouse button has two different functions. Dragging up and down zooms in and out. Dragging left and right rotates the molecule about the Z-axis. When a view window contains more than one molecule, these mouse actions will move all of the separate fragments. To limit the motion to just the closest fragment, hold down the Alt key while using the mouse. We can use the Display tool to change the display in the view window. The Display Format dialog has five tabs: General, Quality, Molecule, Text, and Surface. We can change background color with the General tab and also display or hide specific items such as atom labels or hydrogen atoms. The Quality tab controls the display quality for both stationary objects and moving objects. The sliders vary between fast and realistic, which correspond to the fastest and slowest display times respectively. With fast, the rendering of the molecule is cruder than with realistic. The Molecule tab controls how atoms and bonds are displayed. They are separate settings for the high, medium, and low layers in an onion calculation. For other cases, we use the high layer settings. The default view of a molecule is ball and bond type. For large molecules, wireframe and tube can make the overall structure easier to understand. With the Text tab, we can change the font, size, and color of the text used for atom labels. Here, we zoom in on the molecule and increase the font size. Molecule groups can hold more than one molecule within different frames. If we want to add a new molecule to a molecule group, there are many ways to do so. First, the green plus icon will add a blank view to the current group. Here, we build orthodichlorobenzene. The second way to add a molecule to a molecule group is by pasting. Here, we copy and paste the current molecule, adding another copy to the molecule group. Notice that after we have copied atoms, they become the current fragment, which is labeled as clipboard. Pasting or clicking in a view window will add the copied atoms to the current structure. We modify it to the metaform of dichlorobenzene. The third way to add a new molecule to a molecule group is to open an existing file and make sure to select Add Files to Active Molecule Group from the target dropdown. Once the file opens, the molecule group contains benzene plus all three structural isomer of dichlorobenzene. This field shows the current view's molecule number within the molecule group. The up and down arrows move to the next and previous molecules within the group, respectively. Molecule group information is also shown in the view window's title bar. The initial string indicates the molecule group number, the molecule number within the group, and the view number for that molecule. For some job types, opening the results file displays a multi-view molecule group. For example, here we open the results from an IRC calculation for an SN2 reaction. The molecule group has 21 structures, the transition state, and 10 steps each in the forward and reverse directions. We can animate the molecule group to see the progress along the reaction path. Clicking the down arrow next to the Animation Start button lets us specify parameters for the animation. Clicking the multi-view icon places all of the individual views within a larger window. The individual component windows and molecules can still be manipulated in all of the usual ways. If we right-click in an open area of the window, the multi-view context menu appears. The Fit item will resize all of the component views to best fit into the containing window. Another useful option is Synchronize, which links the movement of the separate views. The preferences for GaussView allow us to change many of the default settings for the program. We can access them using the Toolbar icon or with the File Preferences menu item. The various categories of preferences are in the list on the left. Many of them are similar to the dialogs used elsewhere by GaussView. For example, the display preferences are the same as the settings found in the display format dialog we saw earlier. The color preferences lets you customize colors for various items. Element colors lets you change the default color for the various elements. Here, we are changing the color for manganese using the RGB sliders. Note that we must click OK to apply the color change. The icon preferences control the size of the icons. In this case, all of them have been set to the largest size. The default button reverts settings back to the GaussView defaults. The resulting dialog provides the option for resetting the current preference settings or all preference settings. Here, we reset just the icon preferences.